If you ever tried to connect your website with any external service, maybe connecting with Google Analytics, maybe verifying your website with Google Search Console, maybe Microsoft Clarity, Pinterest, or even adding the Facebook Pixel for that matter, the instructions for any of these services are usually very similar. They'll give you a piece of code or script and ask you to add it either to the header of your website or the footer of your website. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly that, how to add any piece of code or script to the header of your website or the footer of your website. I'm going to demonstrate two different ways to do that. Now, both these methods definitely work, but the first one has some limitations. That's why I would recommend that you watch the video till the end so you can decide for yourself which method is easier for you to implement based on your website and your skill level. Let's get started. So let's talk about method number one to add any piece of code to the header or the footer of your website. And you can do that by using a feature inside WordPress, which is called the theme file editor. If you notice my screen right here, I'm actually inside the theme file editor right now. Inside appearance, you can find the theme file editor even on your website. And once you're here, you have to just do two things or one thing depending on how the code is structured. You have to go into the header.php or the footer.php of your theme files. You can find them right here. Examples, you can see this is the theme header and it's named header.php. I'll click on this. And you also have the theme footer, which is footer.php. And once the file actually loads, all you have to do is go to this section right here and paste the piece of code wherever it's recommended to paste. Sometimes it's after the body or sometimes it's just before the ending. Depending on how the instructions are given to you, you can actually paste the code right here and make sure to update the file and it'll work for you. Now, I understand that this can be overwhelming for beginners, that because you're messing with your theme files directly, but it also has another limitation. Anytime there's an update to the theme, mostly the header and footer files will be overwritten by new versions of the theme. So your changes will completely be lost. You'll have to do this again. The second limitation is that if you decide to change themes at any point, then any pieces of code you have added to one theme will not transfer over to the another theme. So you'll have to copy all those snippets that you've added to one theme and then add it to another theme. So definitely this method can work, but it has obvious limitations. That's why I was saying that, okay, maybe it works for you if you have to add just a small piece of code and you're not going to change your theme, you can definitely use this method. But for most users, even beginners or even seasoned users of WordPress, I would recommend that you look at the method number two, which I'm going to demonstrate right now, because it's more superior and I'd say more easier way of adding any piece of snippet to header, footer and different areas of your website as well. I'm going to talk about that. Let's start with method number two. So let's talk about method number two to add any piece of code to the header or the footer of your website. And the method I would recommend is by using a third party or external plugin on your website. And you don't have to download the plugin from another website. It's already available in the WP repository and it's also free to use. And the plugin's name is WP Code. So right now you can see I'm inside the website's plugin section, add new section or add new page. And I've searched for WP Code and this is the plugin that comes up. And you can look at the ratings and the number of installations. It's a highly rated plugin. So click install now, let the plugin install, let's activate it and I'll show you how to use this plugin to add headers and footers. And I'm going to also talk about some additional features that this plugin provides because it's worth talking about. All right, so plugin has installed, that's activated and I'll demonstrate how to utilize this plugin. Once the plugin is activated, you'll obviously see it in the plugins menu right here, but you'll also see a menu entry for it right here. This is the menu entry. Now, as you can see, you have a bunch of options right here, but since we're talking about headers and footers, I'll focus exclusively on that right now. Let's go into the headers and footer section. This is where you can start adding code to the website or your website, specifically in the header and footer. So I'll open this page up, and this will open up this particular page. Now you have the header section, you have the footer section, but you also have the body section because sometimes you might need to use this feature as well. So wherever the code snippet that you want to paste, maybe in the header or the footer, just go and paste the code snippet right here. For example, I have a sample piece of code right here. I'll paste it in the header section and I'll save my changes. And that's it, I'm done. No messing with themes code files, no trying to work something out where you are feeling overwhelmed, where you can make mistakes. It's that simple. And of course, anytime your theme updates, you don't have to worry. Even if you change themes, this script or these code snippets will not go away. They'll stay persistent throughout whatever changes you make on your website. Now, one thing to keep in mind that if you disable this plugin, of course, the changes that the code snippets actually include or bring to your site will be disabled, but the changes will not be lost permanently. So let's say you are running some diagnostic operations, you're trying to figure out some issues, then you can safely deactivate the plugin. And once you activate it again, the code snippets will not be deleted. They'll still safely stay there. So you can safely deactivate and reactivate the plugin and you will have no troubles with your code snippets. And I think that's pretty useful. And of course, if you want to delete any code snippet later on from your website, just go right here, make the changes, delete it, make sure to update the changes. And if you're not seeing the changes with the specific code snippet, it's also a good idea to usually flush the cache or empty your cache so that the changes can start reflecting on your website. And that, my friends, is the easiest way to add any code snippets to the header, footer, or even the body section of your website. Now, as I was saying, WP code is not limited to just headers and footers. It can do a lot more. You can manage and create code snippets. You have predefined code snippet library that you can directly import code snippets from. You can enable and disable code snippets, even load them conditionally. For example, if you want to disable the admin bar for external users or subscribers of your website and not for yourself, the administrator, instantly do that in just a second. And I'm pretty sure if you're building a website, managing your own website, in the near future, anytime, definitely you're going to utilize any one of or more of the features that WP Code actually provides to you. So if you have a few minutes of free time, I would highly recommend that you watch this video right here, which is an overview of the WP Code plugin. Watching this video is free, the plugin itself is free, and subscribing to the WP Beginners channel is also free. So make sure to subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.